Good morning.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas to each of you and to those who are at home and Mass online with us. Let us gather together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is born for us, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Together with the whole church today, we celebrate the solemnity of the Nativity of the Lord. In this Mass, we ask Jesus to help us to experience the joy, peace, and holiness that God is with us. And we prepare ourselves to receive Jesus in His Word and in His risen through the bread, His body, so that we can be at home with peace, joy, and holiness in our life. Let us now to ask God to forgive all our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
With all the angels and saints, we sing the glory to God. Created the dignity of human nature and still more wonderfully restored it. Grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him who brings glad tidings, announcing peace, bearing good news, announcing salvation, and saying to Zion, your God is king. Hark, your sentinels raise a cry, together they shout for joy, for they see directly before their eyes the Lord restoring Zion. Break out together in song, O ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord comforts his people. He redeems Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm in the sight of all of the nations. All the ends of the earth will behold the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he has spoken to us through his Son, whom he made heir of all things and through whom he created the universe, who is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and who sustains all things by his mighty word. When he had accomplished purification from sins, he took his seat at the right hand of the Majesty on high, as far superior to the angels, as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, you are my son, this day I have begotten you? Or again, I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, let all the angels of God worship him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through Him, and without Him nothing came to be. What came to be through Him was life, and this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him, but the world did not know him. He came to what he was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by a man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. And we saw his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'The one who is coming after me ranks ahead of me, because he existed before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace in place of grace, because while the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. The only Son, God, who is at the Father's side, has revealed him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
All right. Merry Christmas to all again. This morning, I wake up 7 o'clock, I open the gate, and it's too dark. The cloud is so dark. And then I run for a while, and about 10 minutes later, I see the dark clouds become bright with the sun rise. I didn't see the sun yet, but it changed the color on the clouds. And I can see it clear. And around 7:20, the lights become brighter. Everything is so beautiful. And I feel the warmth. It's amazing for me, just simple experience in the morning. It's very different from now. But that helped me to reflect on about about Christmas. That in the gospel, St. John talked about Jesus in the light. And at Christmas, we are now together with the whole church. We celebrate is the birth of Jesus give us that light, that warmness. And we need to celebrate with joy, peace, and holiness. That's what we need to do. Because Jesus come to bring light, cast away darkness. And that light is life for us who believe in Him. So how can we give the joy, peace, and holiness? A challenge for us. But today, Christmas, and Christmas season, we need to keep our faith and live out the truth. Last night I talked about doing good works, but this day, this morning, I'm going to talk about living out the truth. Have faith and living out the truth. So what is the truth that help us to have joy? We cannot have joy without the truth. The truth in the gospel that St. John said in the very last sentence, what's about? No one has ever seen God, the only Son. Who's that Son? God. The Son is God. The only Son, God, who is at the Father's side. And that Son opened the Gospel of John, what he said, that's the Son is the Word. And the Word is with God. The Word was God. The Word was in the beginning. And that Word, St. John said again the Gospel, and the Word became flesh. That's the truth that we need to live it out. We need to have faith in Jesus is God, God's Son, in the Father's side. This was in the beginning. He's the source of everything that God created of this universe. And He became man, was born 2020 years ago. And today we celebrate His birthday. And God's Son named Jesus bring light. So if we stay with that truth, confess God is, Jesus is our God. God make man. Then we have joy. And we listen to His word, His teaching in the gospel. And with that joy within us, with the truth within us, then we know how to live peacefully, to keep the peace. Peace from within that we long for, in our safety, in our security. That those things we can earn by our own, but the peace we cannot earn. Peace is the gift given. Given to human nature after the fall. Fear is conquered. We have no peace. Peace only happens if we totally trust in Jesus, God's Son, God made man, who loved me, who become man, who saved me, who give me light and life. So in order to have peace in Christmas seasons or every day of our life, then we need to meditate how Jesus, He become man. He become man in His humility. Humility
to be humble. The opening prayer talk about that. God humble himself. Being God, he not just flying there, stay there. He become man, lowly. And lowly in the way that he choose a mother, a young girl to be a mother. And the gospel also say very clear, he will not become to be human being in the way that we are thinking by man's decision or by human nature. No, by God. St. John said clear. By the power of the Holy Spirit, Jesus conceived. And then in his humanity, he was born like each one of us. But not in the valleys, not in the hospital or the room properly, but in nowhere in the field, in the manger of the animal. That the humility of Jesus. And if we learn from that, then we know how to respect each other, and we know how to serve in a better way to preserve peace, to keep the peace, to lessen the violence. Being a God, he commands in that lowliness. And later on in life with Jesus, in his humanity, he served people. He served his disciples. He washed the feet. He called everybody, not servant, but friends, brothers and sisters. And then he died for us, for all those who believe in him, and have become the bread of life, body and blood, to feed us again in his last day on earth. In the first day he was born, he already inside the manger as food. The manger contained food. And before he died, he established Eucharist, give himself as food for us who believe, spiritual food for eternity. And that humility of Jesus, if we want to have peace in Christmas, we need to meditate on that and try to serve with that humility. Whoever we are, in our responsibility, in our position, in our ministry. So Christmas help us to have joy and peace if we stay with the truth and serve with humility. And Christmas help us also to have holiness in the way that God is with us. And God the Father give us not just a gift as we have Christmas exchange, the natural one, or the money, or whatever title, authority, or even though in human desire, with earthly desire, body and five senses. Some people give the gift in that way, but not in the way that they think the big gift that they believers need to meditate on is God's Son, God himself, a person. That's why when they prepare for Christmas, they do things so differently. A lot of pictures, Facebook, whatever news, you talk about environment without God, without Jesus. This is holy, happy holy day. And Christmas tree and gift and light. Where is Jesus? Where is the Holy Family, Mary and Joseph? That the sad thing for us who believe. How can we have that holiness in the way without God present? Because what happened in reality, it reflect on our mind, our thought, our desire, our heart. We're not looking for
a God who was born with a manger in our home, but we're looking for something else. How can we become holy? St. John helped us the way how to become holy, to be the testimony for the light by his own life, his way of living. He became a voice for the Lord, a voice to speak the word. And this is the word, is God himself. Don't talk about God. Talk about the Messiah who will come after me, but high rank before me. I'm not worthy until his Sunday. He not only come here with baptized with the water, but he come with the Holy Spirit. Baptize you with the water and Holy Spirit. John talk about that in his life. That's why he's a holy man. Among all human beings, was born by woman. And Jesus said, nobody is greater than John the Baptist. Of course, except Mary, the Immaculate. And that the way John keep the holiness. Voice for God's word. Talk about God. Christmas time, if we don't talk about Jesus, his love to our children, grandchildren, our students, then we lose the sense of Christmas for the next generation. And we already know that experience. When we deny to put away the Merry Christmas, we replace Happy Holiday, or we put away the manger, we only keep Christmas tree and exchange gift. And we put away the mass on the sacraments, then slowly all the worldly thing, desire thing, it occupy our mind, our heart, our relationship. And Christmas is just a way we say hi, hello, say in word, but not really remain joy, peace, and holiness in our life. And that another way that we are believers. It's hard, but we learn. Whatever happened, it happened already. We learn to awaken ourselves with the truth that Jesus, God's Son, come to reveal about the Father to us. Come to say the truth in the gospel. Come to live it out, his life, to serve with humility. And ask disciples, go and proclaim the good news. And share about the truth. And John testified to Jesus. We, or our disciples, testify of the apostles. We also follow Jesus. We try to do that. Become the testimony for Jesus, the light, who is God, with humility. And in that way, I believe peace will come within us. Joy will remain with us. And holiness will pretend our life as a Catholic Christians. And we are good people. And we keep that spirit of peace, joy, and holiness today, Christmas Day. Bring home, share that to your loved ones. Share that to the community. Share that to the whole world, especially our nation. And so, the darkness will go away. And everything getting better in this coming year. May God bless each of you, your loved ones, everybody we pray for, and bless the whole world with peace, joy, and holiness. Amen. We now profess our faith, and when we say the word become man, we bow our head. Together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. First man of our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Together with the whole church, we offer to God our prayer. For Pope Francis, may God continue to bless him with vitality as he shepherds his flock. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For legislators and policymakers, may the Lord guide their decision making in order to protect the lives of the unborn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who feel lonely this Christmas season, may Jesus bring them comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families gathered today, as we seek to emulate the model of the Holy Family of Nazareth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have got sick, especially for parents of Mario and his brother-in-law, Robert Eckert, and many of our loved ones as well, whom we promise to pray, may the healing of God help them to be healthy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, our loved ones, today the Mass we offer for all the members of St. John's who passed away. We remember our loved ones as well. May they rejoice in the heaven with the risen Christ and all the angels and saints. We pray to the Lord. Each of us ask for the grace special in this Christmas season with our loved ones to keep the joy, peace, and holiness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Father of love and mercy, in your goodness, you sent us your Son, whose birth we celebrate today. We ask that you hear and answer these prayers through Christ our Lord. pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your heart.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word make flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. For these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let it do for, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread out the word, bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember those whom we pray today in this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who are dying in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grants her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Those who are at home, please pray with me for your Holy Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Here is your God. let us pray.
Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world, born this day, is the offerer of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver even of immortality, who lives rest forever and ever.
Amen.
Please, we have an announcement from Father Sergio.
Good morning, all of you. And Merry Christmas. I think that this is a beautiful day again. We are happy because we celebrate that Jesus Christ is among us. So thank you for being here in this Eucharist. And I know that you spent a very good night last night with your family, your friends, and I can see in your face as well, part of your face. I cannot see all your faces, but I'm sure that you spent a good time with your families. So today we start with Christmas. It is not that we finish Christmas, as many people think, no? So today we start Christmas. So let us keep living this happiness in our hearts for the rest of the season of Christmas. You know, Christmas is until the baptism of Jesus Christ. So be happy, because Jesus Christ is among us. He is the Emmanuel. He wants to come to be among us. This is the love of God among us, Jesus Christ. It is why we are happy here, and we are happy in the world, because the light is among us. So, yes, I would like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a blessed and different New Year, with more blessings that we received this year. So let us keep loving each other, and especially give Jesus Christ to all of our brothers and sisters, especially those who need the presence of the Lord in their hearts. So thank you for being part of our community. And I would like to take the opportunity to all of you who have been very faithful to our community, participating in the Eucharist, participating in different activities that we still have in our church. And we'd like to give thanks to all of you who participate in this, the ushers, those who help us with the transit, with the cars, those who are filming for people who are not able to come, the choir, and those who participate in the liturgy. So I would like to really give you thanks for many, many blessings that you are giving us every day. So, yes, I would like to wish you again a very, very and Merry Christmas, and really that the Lord is in your heart and keep him the rest of your lives. Merry Christmas to all of you.
Merry Christmas.
Say Merry Christmas to Father also.
All right, and great day. Now, I don't know if it's raining afternoon, but I hope the Spanish Mass will be a good weather as well. And also, I think Mario did a great thing here many days, actually. He's run out of steam. We have to say thanks to him. And all of you, of course, in the choir, as Father mentioned. I know we are faithful people. Last night, half a car here, and this morning, a half. So you are all faithful people every Sunday. You break down another half last night. Another half now, and many of you at two masses. That's your serving. So we continue to pray and keep Christmas season, as I mentioned, joy, peace, and holiness. I think we have to ask God to bless us with a special blessing. So let us now bow your head for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy day, drive far from you the darkness of vice,
and illumine your heart with the light of virtue. Amen. May God, who willed that the great joy of His Son's saving birth be announced to the shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness He gives, and make you heralds of His gospel.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gifts of His peace and favor, and make you sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Lord, in the peace of Christ.
Thank you, God.